Joining me now is the Daily Telegraph's Jonathan Moran with the latest from the world of entertainment. Jonathan, hello. Tell us about Meghan Markle's mate, British actress and activist Jamila Jamil, who came out as queer this week in response to criticism of her for taking a role that many thought should be performed by a member of the black LGBT community.
Firstly, Rita, thank you for having me on your show. I've been watching you for a long time and we may disagree on some things, but I'm very pleased to be part of this. Just about this Jamila Jamil story, just to be... I guess the question is, she's been forced to come out of the closet as queer because she's working on a show that has some links to queer content. I find it confusing at best. I'm gay myself, but I don't prescribe to the theology or the belief system, sorry, that you have to be gay to then talk about gay things. And I also don't think that voguing is gay. So this television show is called Legendary. It sounds like Big Brother with voguing dancing, and basically have all these people competing as that. And she's one of the judges, and people have criticised it because they didn't know that she had a queer link. And I just think that's stupid to feel that people have to be related in that sense.
Absolutely. Look, I think you and I are going to butt heads as we go along in this program because we're sort of different sides of the political spectrum. But on this
Which
one,
is
we
good.
Agree. Well, yeah, because I think you shouldn't have, say, a gay role performed only by gay actors. They're acting. That's the part of the whole thing. I mean, this follows
It's just stupid.
It is stupid. There was so much criticism of the BAFTAs for being too white and too male, the BAFTAs being like the British Oscars. Even the award winner, one of the big award winners of the night, Joaquin Phoenix, he said he was really upset about the lack of diversity. It didn't stop him accepting the award and showing up. But is there a genuine problem with racism and sexism and just general bigotry in the movie industry?
All right, here's the bit where we might butt heads on. Actually, we might agree on it. I just think there's no surprises to me that the awards season has been dominated by white, middle-class, beautiful people. There is a lack of diversity there. But is that those people's fault? And what Joaquin Phoenix has said is that he's complicit or compliant in as part of the problem. The fact is, Hollywood is an old boys' club filled with boys who make decisions, and that's what it is. Like
it's also the most left-wing, far left, I would argue, progressive little bubble. So how can that world still be so sexist and backward in how it does things when its politics are all about celebrating minorities and empowering women and empowering people from different backgrounds?
Yeah, I mean, that's the big question, isn't it? Why is it doing this when there's so many of those stories on our screen? Well, the fact is then must be Hollywood is a business. It's driven by business decisions. So what do people want to see? They want to see stories that touch people, whether that's gender stuff or whether it's racial stuff or whatever. But the fact is, when it comes to award season, the people voting for the awards are the top tier, and those people that are making the decisions in the industry, and they're not giving the awards that way. But is it, I mean, maybe, and is it such a bad thing if the awards just went to the people that deserve to get the awards? Do they have to?
Exactly.
Do we have to say whether they're black, white, purple, or whatever? I just think that's absolutely bloody stupid. I'd like to see more representation across the board, but I'd also like to ride a rainbow to work every day, you know, like, and that's not possible. So I just think it's bloody stupid.
Well, we're agreeing again, and this is just
this is weird.
So it's making both of us very uncomfortable because I'm just sick of this obsession, this preoccupation with what's your gender, what's your sexual orientation, what's your ethnicity, what's your religious beliefs. How about just judging people based on their character and the quality of their work? And if a particular movie or a performance is the best, then you don't worry about the colour of the person. You just give them the award. I mean, I know it's crazy in 2020 to talk like this.
And if Joaquin Phoenix is so high and mighty, then give your next role to someone else then, mate. If you don't want the roles, shouldn't it just go to the best person? He was the best person to play Joker in that movie, and he got the awards for it. If it was a black person or whatever, or a woman playing the Joker, I don't think I'd care, as long as it's a good movie.
That's it. And if you're going to grandstand, then at least have some principle and don't show up and accept the award. Say, I don't want to be a party to this white night where there's no diversity and no people of colour being celebrated. Stay home, let someone else get the award. And then you're actually making a real point. Now, just quickly on the Oscars, what can we look forward to there?
I mean, Rita, I only care about what people wear. I made a famous mistake once with Cate Blanchett, and I know it's controversial to ask women what they wear. I said to her one night on a red carpet, Cate, who dressed you? And she said, I dressed myself and kept walking. Look, 1917 is going to be good. It's all the... Joaquin Phoenix is going to win for the Joker. If we're going to see lots of white people, but we'll also see lots of black people and we'll see lots of gay people. They just won't have it branded on their foreheads. And I personally think that's the way it should be.
Well, yeah, well, I wouldn't be surprised if there will be badges in the future. You'd just be ticking different diversity boxes just to make sure you should be allowed to attend.
All right, I'm going to chuck a rainbow on my forehead next time we talk then.
That's it. I don't know what symbol I can have, I don't know, for atheist women of colour, but I'll find one and I'll put it on there. Thank you. Next week, we'll have a bit more time to chat. Stay with us. I've got more coming up next.